going to make the confession that I'm also not an archaeologist. My background is in volunteer management and working with people, and I'm hoping that some of the results of our study might fit into ways that you might want to move with archaeology. So first up, just for a little bit of an intro, my role at Birmingham Museums Trust is to work with our volunteers. As an organisation, we're a charity and we look after 9 sites across the city of Birmingham. These range from an art gallery to a science museum, a working water mill, to the remains of a 700-year-old moated manor house. And over the course of a year, we can work with up to about 1,000 people through a variety of volunteering projects, short-term to long-term. I also wanted to start with the context of where we are based. So Birmingham is an incredibly diverse city. When we look at the latest census results, just under half the population is under the age of 30, so we have an incredibly young population. 42% of the population classify themselves as coming from a BAME background. 18% describe themselves as having a disability, and also the city of Birmingham is estimated to be home to 60,000 LGBT plus citizens. So all our museums are spread across this incredibly diverse city. And what we did a couple of years ago was we really wanted to make sure that these museums and this heritage felt like it belonged to the people. And we thought that through volunteering, that was a really good way to go. So in 2015-16, we ran a research project. And the idea of this research was to look at why people might not choose to volunteer with us. There's been a whole range of research done on the motivations to volunteer, but maybe not so much on those barriers and what's stopping people from making that decision. I thought I'd put this one up here first. So our question, one of the questions that we asked in a survey, which was done online and through face-to-face interviews, was why are people not interested in volunteering and why are you not interested in volunteering? This wasn't on its own. So people might feel it would embarrass them if they were spotted by their mates. For us, this was a little bit heartbreaking because we're all passionate about heritage. We're passionate about the buildings we look after. But what we're seeing is actually maybe they're not relevant for people right now, and some of the ways that we're working don't make people feel like they can be involved. Some of the other things that came up through our question to what's stopping people were things to do with time and their ability to give some of their time with their busy lives. They didn't know that it was even possible to get involved with us. They didn't know, they had this preconception that maybe they wouldn't fit in with what we were all about. And also they didn't care about us. So when we see these results, as someone that's passionate about sharing heritage with people, it was a really hard pill to take. When we go on to them describing what they thought a museum volunteer would be like, it was even more depressing. So these are not the only results. We had positive results as well. We have a lovely volunteer team. But some of the things that were coming up were the assumption that volunteers were either old or a student, that they were boffin-like, that they had to have some form of expertise, and dare I say it, they were a little bit dull. So these were some of the main trends that we saw throughout our data. And actually, when I look at our volunteer data at the time that we ran this report, we actually had quite a diverse team. So on average, the people that were applying to volunteer with us were aged 29. We had kind of a 20% applications from males, and we were doing okay in terms of our applications from those with a BAME background. But actually, it was kind of irrelevant, this data, if when we asked the frank questions to the people who might want to get involved, they didn't see this. So this might have been the reality, but we were somehow perpetuating this idea that this wasn't what it was like to be part of our organisation. We worked with 400 responses, for some through an online survey, which we promoted through Facebook and other social media channels, and also from face-to-face interviews. What we really wanted to make sure was that the people that were responding hadn't volunteered in the museum before, so they might be interested in volunteering, but not necessarily within heritage. So some of the key findings were that, first of all, 70% of our responses didn't know about some of the benefits that volunteering could bring. So we've already heard today about some amazing projects which really help people with their skills, their careers, might help them with their own well-being. But quite often people were unaware that we offer travel expenses, that a volunteering relationship is a two-way relationship. We don't just expect time, we give back lots and lots of different opportunities for people. 57% of the people that applied didn't know that they could volunteer with us at all, which suggested there was definitely a problem in terms of communication and how we were selling our opportunities. And then we're also a charity, so 45% of the people who replied didn't actually know that that information about us as an organisation. Our particular research motivation, we decided to look at the 42% of people from BAME background who are citizens of Birmingham. And we felt that the 34% at the moment within our own volunteer body wasn't really reflective of that diversity. So we had a particular motivation with our research to look at BAME respondents. And what we found was actually they were 5% more likely to want to volunteer, but 17% less likely to know they could. So there was definitely a motivation there to give something back. We're a charity, we really weren't showing that. So we've got this research from a couple of years ago. What are we going to do about it? What are we doing about it? I'm a little bit cheesy. I like to think it's a journey. There's not a definite finished outcome, but we really wanted to work on 4 points in order to change some perceptions of our programme and of our organisation. Our first one was to communicate that we were a charity. That was obviously something that people didn't realise. We do lots of work through community engagement. We keep these buildings alive. We have free buildings that people can come for their own well-being. And we weren't showing that. We wanted to showcase our opportunities. There was definitely an assumption that in order to volunteer with us, you had to be white, middle class and a bit dull and come every Tuesday morning and say hello. But actually we had a whole range of things that we weren't telling people, that they could come for one day a year, that we ran short-term projects. And that it definitely wasn't about being an expert. There was, from some of the information that came in, people thought they needed a degree in history to be part of who we were. And that really isn't the case. A lot of our opportunities, you just need to have enthusiasm and a willingness to get involved. Obviously, there are some expert roles too, but we really wanted to be for everyone. And we also want to show people that we give something back. We're not a closed organisation. We're not that museum that you kind of see and you go, oh, I don't belong there. We want people to feel that they can belong, and that does involve, as people have mentioned earlier, us going out into the community and talking to people. There isn't a closed door there. We have to actively go to people and talk about it before they know that they can come to us. So has it worked? Well, I like to think it's not a set kind of will it work, will it won't work. We wanted to ask those frank questions. It was heartbreaking to get the results, but that was what the people of Birmingham thought about us, so we wanted to change that. We have seen a little bit of progress over the 2 years, so our average age of applicant has gone down a couple of years, but really focusing on our particular research motivation and looking at the BAME background, that's gone from 34% to 37%. So it's a small step, and actually this session's all about archaeology for change, and for us Birmingham is always changing, so it's really about how we continue to keep relevant to the people of Birmingham. If we want to be here in another 100 years, we have to be relevant to the people. It's about our sustainability. And I wanted to end a little bit with another quote. Once a year we survey our volunteers and see how their journey's going. And so this came back that they enjoyed everything, they got new skills, they gave something back. And I think in the past we might have patted ourselves on the back and said, brilliant, we've done a great job, sorted. But actually what this project showed was that that is fabulous, that is brilliant. Our volunteers who are with us are having a good time, but we can't just stop there, because if we want to be here, we need the people to feel that they love us and that we're part of their city. Thank you very much.